Welcome morning, children. For the next 4 weeks, we will be finishing off a series on Elisha. Do you remember who Elisha was? He was a prophet, which means he was chosen by God for a special job. He was to tell the people of Israel to turn back to God. Before Christmas, we saw that Elisha showed the people what God is like through his miracles, that he has the power to rescue and save. Our passage today is from 2 Kings and is about a woman. This woman didn't need anything. She didn't even have a problem. This woman and her husband had a lot of money. They had everything that they needed. She also believed that Elisha was a holy man of God. So she made for him a room in her house, and it had a bed in it, a bedside table, and a lamp, so that whenever he visited, he could stay there. Elisha was so thankful that he wanted to help the woman. But she had a house. She even had a husband, but she didn't have a child though. So Elisha called the woman and promised her that God would give her a son. And he did. Years later, when the child grew up, he went to his father. "Ow, my head." "Take him to his mother," the father said. So he went to his mum until noon. Then he died. The woman took her son and placed him in Elisha's room. Then she took a donkey and travelled a long way to Elisha to ask him for help. Elisha told her to go back to her son with her servant and to place a staff on the boy. But nothing happened. So Elisha went up to the room and laid on the boy twice and prayed. The boy returned to life again. He opened his eyes and sat up. Elisha took him back to his mother. In the passage, the woman trusted Elisha. And we know this because she made a special room for him. And when her son was sick, she went straight to Elisha. She knew that only he could help her. No amount of money could save her. Only Elisha, because he was the one who promised her that God would give her a son, and he did. And it was God, rather than Elisha, who restored the boy's life. Only God has that kind of power. This is because God is in control of all things. So those who put their trust in God do not need to be afraid of anything, even death. I'm going to show you some pictures, and I want you to decide who you think has more power. Children, there are some powerful things in our world, but God is more powerful than all of them. We know this is true because he demonstrated his power over life and death through his son at the cross. Jesus died and rose again, proving that not even death has power over Jesus. Jesus has power over everything. And those who trust in Jesus have the hope of life after death, forever with him. This means that we don't need to fear the things of this world, because our greatest problem of death has been dealt with once and for all. So we will hear of people still dying, we will feel sad, and we will miss our loved ones. But we don't need to fear death, because we will be raised to life again with Jesus, where there will be no pain, no sadness, and no death. There is no one else who can offer such hope or save us from death. Only Jesus. Let me pray now. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for your Son, Jesus. We thank you that he is the only one who has power over everything, and that because of his death and resurrection, we have the hope that we will get to live with you forever. Please help us not to fear death, but to keep trusting in you and to hope in the life to come. Amen.